Hi guys, today's quick video is all about revision techniques and I'm sharing with you the blurting revision technique, which I'm sure lots of you are aware of, but I'm going to show you how I actually use it. So if we have a look at what I've done here, now I've just been sitting using my revision guide, but it doesn't matter what you use, you can use your textbook, your school notes, videos, whatever, but I've been sat here making a revision page on the circulatory system. So that is all things to do with the heart. So I've drawn my diagram, which has been simplified, showing my heart, making sure I remember that the left side is actually on the right side is on the left side. So we have the left atrium and the left ventricles, the right atria and the right ventricles, and I'm showing the way the blood is flowing. And I've made a note here that veins carry blood towards the heart. So we know that the vena cava is a vein and the pulmonary vein is a vein. Notice that pulmonary means relating to the lungs. So where has this vein come from? Well, it's come from the lungs carrying oxygenated blood. So I like to be very careful when I make my revision notes and make sure that they are super detailed, but not writing too much because you don't want to overwrite. You don't want to be writing yards of notes when it comes to revising. Let's zoom in again and have a look at the next point, which is to do with the coronary arteries. So what are they? Well, they're arteries which supply the heart with its own oxygen requirements. Then I've gone into huge amounts of detail about coronary heart disease, so that's CHD, because this can be a 5-6 mark question. Made lots of notes, which I actually got from my revision guide. And then lastly, I've just made a quick note on the structure of the arteries, veins and capillaries. The easiest thing here for me to do is to draw them out. I should probably draw some valves in here just to make sure they're detailed. But I can see that the artery has a narrow lumen compared with the vein. The capillary has an extremely small lumen and it's only one cell thick. So let's get on to the blurting technique. So all I'm going to do now to try and get this into my head, because there's no point constantly writing out notes. You've got to actually test that you can remember them in your brain. So I'm going to set a timer on my stop clock for exactly 2 minutes and I'm not going to have any distractions and I'm going to sit here and learn it. Learn it, and actually see in my mind where the various bits are on the page. So I'm going to think about the fact that the diagram of the heart is in the top left corner, the fact that I've made a note about where the arteries and veins go on the right of that. The middle chunk consists of everything to do with coronary heart disease, and then towards the bottom I'm going to have to try and remember that I drew arteries, veins and capillaries. So when I think about revising these things, I actually see the page in my brain so that when I blurt it, it should look very similar to what I have here. Anyway, let's get learning. So I'm going to set a timer for 2 minutes. The time frame you need to use will vary. It could be 30 seconds. It will vary depending on the topic, how much information you have. But for me, I think 2 minutes is reasonable. To move all my revision materials out of the way, I've got an identical piece of paper. Look, this is just scrap paper that's got maths on it. I used to keep a huge stock of scrap paper when I was revising. So it's time to go. So the heart. Right, we had a diagram of the heart. I remember this. I labelled the atria, remembering which way round they went, the ventricles, the vessels coming into the heart, the vessels coming out, and I showed the direction of the blood, which was in this direction. I know that arteries carry blood away, and notice I'm writing this incredibly quickly and in less detail compared with my notes. This is blurting, so this is going straight in the bin afterwards. This was the aorta because it carried oxygenated blood. This is carrying blood to the lungs, which is why it's the pulmonary artery. So that's deoxygenated. This came from the lungs, which is why it's the pulmonary vein, and it's a vein because it's carrying blood to the heart. This came from the body. It was carrying deoxygenated blood. So that was done. I don't remember there being anything else there. Then I moved on to coronary heart disease, and I made a statement that these arteries supply the heart with its own oxygen. So I'm writing a bit in shorthand here. Then I talked about the steps leading to coronary heart disease, something about the narrowing of the arteries, due to, I think it was cholesterol. What did that mean? Well, it meant that insufficient oxygen could reach the heart muscle, meaning that anaerobic, so that's respiration not involving oxygen, took place. And one of the byproducts of anaerobic respiration was lactic acid. And I'm struggling to remember anything else, so I'm going to leave that there. Then I think there was a chunk at the bottom to do with arteries, veins, and capillaries. And I think this diagram looked a bit like this. You can see they're incredibly rough. So what can I see here? Well, I can see that's a very narrow lumen. This was a wide lumen. And this was only one cell thick, so very narrow. Is there anything else? No, I can't think of anything else. Okay, so at this point, hopefully you'll see that took me hardly any time in terms of trying to remember it, now blurting out all the information. Then I sit here with my two pages side by side and I compare them and see what I forgot. So I'm pretty pleased with my heart diagram. I think that's pretty accurate. I left out a few steps here on coronary heart disease, so I should have added the fact that it decreased the pH and the enzymes denatured, which is why I'm adding those notes here. And I should probably make a note that I forgot that. And then lastly, looking at the arteries, veins and capillaries, we're pretty good here. I forgot to actually discuss the muscle and elastic fibre walls, so that's something I need to remember. And I forgot to mention the valves. I would use this opportunity of blurting to highlight the bits I actually struggle to remember, which is the end bit of the coronary heart disease topic, the bit about the valves and the thick muscle and elastic fibre walls. So hopefully you can see that I'm now confident with what I know, and I've highlighted the bits that I don't know, so that when it comes back to revising it, I know the things that need particular attention paying to them. This piece of paper, straight in the bin. Right, I hope you found that helpful, guys. I really enjoyed doing it, actually. It's good to remember how I used to revise myself. Don't forget to like and sub. I'll be back soon.